in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. For Christ is born of Mary and gathered all above. While mortals sleep and angels keep their watch of wandering love, all morning stars together proclaim the
shepherds, abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And the angel of the Lord came upon them, and they were sore afraid. But the angel said, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy. For unto you is born this day a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." And suddenly there was, with the angel, a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, and goodwill to men."
O holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in, be born to us today.
Thank you. celebration of the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, we at St. Andrew's welcome you to our celebration. We give thanks for our youth choir, Linda Blanchard and Sean Fleming, who have put together our wonderful pageant. Merry Christmas to you all.
On this Christmas Eve, we sing songs of today and songs from ancient times. Our song, Gaudete, is a joyful celebration of Christ's birth, written 600 years ago.
Gaudete, Gaudete, Christus et Sanctus, ex Maria Virgine, Gaudete, 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 Christus et Sanctus, ex Maria Virgine, Gaudete.
Campus aureus grotae, hoc vado papamus, caramina titie, debut adedamus.
Gaudete, Gaudete, Christus et Sanctus, ex Maria Virgine, Gaudete, 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 Christus et Sanctus, ex Maria Virgine, Gaudete.
Deus homo functus est, patur admirante, mundus renovatus est, a Christo regante.
Gaudete, Gaudete, Christus et Sanctus, ex Maria Virgine, Gaudete, 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 Christus et Sanctus, ex Maria Virgine, Gaudete.
Tago nostra conteo, salus omilustro, benedica Domino, salus et in nostro.
Gaudete, Gaudete, Christus et Sanctus, ex Maria Virgine, Gaudete. Gaudete, Gaudete, Christus et Sanctus, ex Maria Virgine, Gaudete.
And now, with pageantry and with song, as our mothers and fathers before us have done, we tell the story of our people, who long ago were waiting for a Messiah to come.
In a faraway land called Nazareth, long, long ago, there lived a young woman named Mary, who loved God very much. One day, when Mary was all alone, God sent an angel to give her a message. The angel's name was Gabriel, and he came to her and said,
"Hail, O favored one, the Lord is with you."
But Mary was frightened, because she didn't know why the angel had come. And the angel said to her,
"Do not be afraid, Mary, for you are blessed among women. You shall have a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and his kingdom shall never end."
And Mary said to the angel,
"What can this be, since I have no husband?"
And the angel said to her,
"The Holy Spirit shall come upon you, and the power of the Most High shall overshadow you. The child that is born of you shall be holy, and shall be called the Son of God."
And Mary said,
"Behold, I am God's handmaiden. Let it happen to me as you have said."
And the angel departed from her.
Mary, Now, Mary was betrothed to a good man named Joseph. God sent an angel to Joseph to visit him in a dream, as Joseph was sleeping.
Joseph, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for her baby is of the Holy Spirit. She will have a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, and he will save his people from their sins.
Joseph awoke from sleep, and he remembered the angel from his dream.
Thank you, God, for helping me to understand. I will take Mary as my wife, and I will honor her.
And now at that time, the Roman Emperor Caesar Augustus decreed that everyone had to go to the city of their birth in order to pay their taxes. And so, even though their baby was to be born soon, Joseph and Mary were required to make the long journey to Bethlehem. When they finally reached the town, the weary couple tried to find a place to stay at an inn.
I hope you are not seeking a room, for I'm sorry to say that I have none.
Can you tell us where we might go?
We don't need much, just a quiet place to lie down.
Well, if you don't mind the animals, we have a stable that will be warm and safe. You are welcome to sleep there for the night.
We're so glad to have a place to rest.
Thank you for your kindness.
And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn.
And in that region, there were shepherds out in the field keeping watch over their flocks by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them,
Be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which will come to all people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger.
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying,
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace and goodwill to all people.
When the angels went away from them, the shepherds said to one another,
Come, let us go even to Bethlehem. We will see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us.
Now, at the time Jesus was born in Bethlehem, King Herod was ruler of Judah. And wise men from the east came to Jerusalem and said to Herod,
Where is he who has been born king of the Jews?
For we have seen a star in the east.
We have come to worship him.
Still bright.
And lo, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you.
continue our celebration with Eucharistic Prayer B. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Because you gave Jesus Christ, your only Son, to be born for us, who, by the mighty power of the Holy Spirit, was made perfect man of the flesh of the Virgin Mary, his mother, so that we might be delivered from the bondage of sin and receive power to become your children. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil, made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son and his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, where with Andrew and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. The gifts of God for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. May Christ, our infant Savior, give you the joy of the Bethlehem shepherds, the awe of the worshiping sages, and the humility and love of the Holy Family. May you become as little children, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you forever. Amen. Amen.